say that that old adage about sell Rosh Hashanah, buy Yom Kippur, that kind of worked, didn't it?
It worked, although if our Cashman were here, he'd tell you the rule is you have to buy tomorrow morning, right? Because if you're observing Yom Kippur, you cannot buy the close today.
That's
so,
right.
Yes, but it is. We're down a couple of percent or 3% since before Rosh Hashanah. That has worked, and I do think it also tells you there's been this sort of anxiety back and forth within this trading range. Yesterday, S&P down 45 points, most of it in the last hour. Today, we got 26 of it back. But where do we end up? Exactly where we closed 6 days ago. So it's not saying nothing's going on. What's going on is the market is kind of hanging in there and waiting and staying supported by low yields and a 2% economy, hoping that, in fact, there's some kind of a catalyst either from trade or some swing in the macro data that gets it moving one way or the other.
Chris, what have you been focused on most of all the last couple of weeks to decide your risk sentiment?
Yeah, I tell you, you know, as Mike said, you know, investors have really hit the pause button at all wealth levels across the board, whether you're the private client side or the institutional side. The pause button's been clearly hit. But the key is the market's been hanging in there. It's in this movement. It tried for a fourth wave of a rotation from ultra defensives to cyclicals, and it didn't really get that big push up in the wave. So then things relaxed itself. But the four main areas where we continue to watch is just like electricity in the household. You got to look at the meter. The meter is this, monetary policy. Check the box. It got more assertive. And the market tried to applaud it. But if we talked about balance sheet expansion literally a few weeks ago or a few months ago, the market would have taken that and ran with it. It's kind of hanging in there at this point. E, the earnings. T, trade. E, election risk. That's a big discussion lately. And then last but not least, recessionary concerns. So all those things within the meter is what most of our clients are paying attention to.
Mark, isn't it possible we keep talking about some kind of trade resolution, whether we get a deal or don't get a deal? But isn't it possible we sort of stay in this gray area for some time to come? And then what do you do?
Yeah, because, I mean, if you think about it, do the Chinese really have an incentive to get a deal done right now? Or might they drag their feet a little bit and see what happens with the 2020 election? So, you know, I believe that they don't have a huge incentive to get a deal done right now. If there is no deal, I think we stay range bound. I think we continue to balance between 28.25 and 30.25. So we do need some sort of a deal in order for us to finally break through. Now, one thing to keep in mind is, you know, mid-October is when seasonality is finally on our side again, right? So if you go back to 1950, roughly 40% of the annual returns of the S&P 500 happened in the fourth quarter. So that is something to look forward to.